Hey guys, it's Tiara. Welcome back to my channel. Basically, I have been throwing my money at Sephora over the last couple of months with their Black Friday sale, with their Christmas sale, with the other things that I don't need but I buy anyway sale, things that I apparently need and need to replenish times and moments, and also the impulsive moments that, you know, I just do and buy even though I don't really need it, but I trick my mind into thinking that I do. Today is going to be a beauty haul, and I haven't been doing this for a long time. Like, the last haul I did was a Japan one, and then I did a collective haul, but today is gonna be all beauty stuff. Disclaimer, some of the items, or rather majority of the items, I have already unboxed and I have already used. And but that there is one true unboxing that I have right here. Yes, so this package came and it is from Sephora, and I do not know why it is cling wrap, but it is. So we will unbox this at the end because I have other stuff that is already out in open air. Before we begin with my beauty haul, do remember to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and of course hit the notification bell so that you'll be notified as to when I upload a brand new video. Let's jump right into this beauty haul. The first thing I have here is this this is the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray, and it came with the dual pack in the honey collection or something like that. So when Christmas time comes around, the season of gifting is one of my favorite times to go to Sephora because there are so many amazing deals. So this was one of them that I thought was so good. One of these, if you have purchased this before, is around $48 to $50 each. But for this, in this set, you pay $78 for two full size of the All Nighter Setting Spray. So as you can see, this one is empty because I have already, I'm already using one. But this was just an amazing deal that I could not pass because I use this quite often and quite regularly, and it runs out pretty quickly, and I also use it in my kit as well. This is the Beauty Blender All That Glitters Blend and Defend Kit. So it comes with two beauty blenders and a beauty blender holder or a case, which I have never tried before. I've never tried their case, so I'm really excited to try. And I haven't even unboxed this yet because I still have a lot of sponges that I have in store and I haven't even used them. But I feel like I kind of miss using a beauty blender because I've been using like a lot of Brava Artistry, Chi Chi Cosmetics, and what else do I use? I tried a Brina Beauty sponge, and it's quite good as well. So yeah, I thought I missed it, so that's why I got it. And I forgot how much this cost. I think this was about like $52 for two beauty blenders when when original price of one is $32. So it's a lot of savings lah. Next up are products from Anastasia Beverly Hills. So I have heard about their, everyone knows about their Brow Wiz, right? Everyone raves about it, but I never really got around to try it simply because I find that I don't know whether I should be spending $40 on a brow pencil. So I thought I'd try it for my makeup kit with, and I don't have the box anymore because I threw it away. But I highly recommend getting this kit right here. I'll put a photo right here. And I think they are still available in Sephora. So you pay $55 and you get the one Brow Wiz pencil full size, a deluxe size of the tinted brow gel in the shade medium brown, and you also get a small size of the clear brow gel. I love the clear brow gel, so I'm probably gonna buy a full size of this when I run out. But I thought that it was such a great deal. Like, you get the pencil, which is originally $40, and you get two of these deluxe size of the brow gel, which I think is a pretty solid deal. And if I'm not wrong, they have like other sets as well, so you can go and check out which one you prefer. And then also I got individually another Brow Wiz pencil, and I got one in the shade medium brown, and this one, I think this is in the shade soft brown. So these two are in my kit, and so far I have been loving using them because they're just very easy to draw, they're very fine and all. Next up is a skincare item. This is the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream, Intense Hydration for Dry, Parched Skin. I got this because I was running low of my moisturizer in my makeup kit, and Jana from Blushes and Bouquets, a makeup artist here in Singapore, she highly recommended this for her makeup kit, or for your makeup kit, or for my makeup kit, because she says that this is very good for sensitive skin and it does a very great job at moisturizing and prepping the skin before makeup. And then I also got a new concealer brush from Sigma. This is the F75, and it's dirty right now because I used it like a couple of days ago. I do feel like it is still thick for my liking. For brows, I use this to carve out brows and to neaten them. It's not bad, but I wish that they made concealer brushes like slightly thinner, because it is still quite thick in my opinion, and it's kind of hard for you to, like, you know, get that crisp line sometimes. But it does work, and I like the brush, I like the bristles on it, so it has worked pretty well. I just wish that it was thinner. Next, I got another of the NARS Soft Matte Complete Concealer, which is the one that comes in a pot in the shade Medium to Ginger. And then I actually went to Sephora a couple of days ago actually to pick up a foundation for my makeup kit as well. And I was inspired to get it because of my sister-in-law Dayang, and she got this foundation for her makeup kit to suit like different skin types of her clients. So I thought that was a pretty good idea, because currently I only have I usually bring around two foundations, and it's the MAC Studio Fix Fluid Foundation, and I just use lightener drops to adjust the shades to how light my client's skin tone is. Even though I like that foundation, it can be a little bit too drying for those with dry skin, so I decided to get the NARS Sheer Glow in the shade Stromboli, which is medium 3. And why I was even thinking about getting this as well, other than being inspired by Dayang, was because I personally use this foundation and I love it. So since I've already tried it and I'm confident that it works and wears very well, I am pretty confident that it worked well on my clients as well. So I got this, and unfortunately for Sheer Glow, they don't have a pump, it's a screw cap, so the pump came at $10. So I got that as well. Before I open that box, right, I thought I would share with you some new lip products that I got. And they are from Syed Dewa, who is a makeup artist from Malaysia, and I love his makeup work and I love his YouTube channel as well. There was a video that I did whereby I followed Syed Dewa's makeup tutorial, and I just love how the look ended up looking like, even though like it's not perfect, like, it's not too dirty as how he did it. But I am a big fan of his, and the other day he was at Celeb Fest and I decided to drop by and get some of his liquid matte lipsticks, because I know that he uses them for his brides and they look so bridal perfect. Like, I cannot even. I got 4 of their products, but 2 of them are of the same shade because I wanted one for myself. So the one that I'm wearing right now is in the shade Manila, and I have some gloss over it, but oh my god, I love the lipstick. It's so pretty, I love it. And it's so comfortable as well. The other 2 shades I got are for my makeup kit, and along with the other Manila shade, and I got in the shade Jakarta and Paris. These are the 3 shades that I got. This is Paris, this is Jakarta, and this is Manila. And Manila is the one that I have on my lips. I love Paris, and I can imagine mixing it with Jakarta to create like a very nice nude lip for a bridal look. Last but not least, we're gonna open up this box right here. This is a true unboxing. It's time for me to open. They were having 20% off for some of the brands in Sephora, but not all of them. I got some that are, you know, part of the 20%, but some of them are not. But because I just wanted it, and it was not available in store, and I just couldn't deal with it. So paper. Aha! I got a Topshop voucher, which, oh, maybe I can buy jeans with this. Oh, okay. I only bought 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I only bought 5 products, but it was a lot of money. The 110 face shape brush from Zoeva was a recommendation by Weebit. When we went to her makeup workshop, she recommended this to apply cream contour. And I also got the pencil brush because I realized that I don't have a lot of pencil brushes in my collection, so I need it for my makeup kit. I also got myself the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz in the shade Soft Brown, and this is for my own use because I'm very curious to see how much I would like this on my brows. If you have seen me do like my own brows or when I do my makeup, you know that I have very thick brows, so I don't know if I really need this or I don't know. We'll have to see and find out. So trying this for the first time. And then the next one, I have the Laura Mercier Caviar Stick Eye Color in the shade Copper, yes. So unfortunately, I missed out getting that set of four mini caviar sticks from Laura Mercier because they ran out, they sold out. So I decided to get the full size of it. This is the same as my Moonlight, the one that I have in shade Moonlight, but it's in the shade Copper, and it's this very pretty gold shade. Again, this is Wiwit's recommendation as well for brights. She just applies this on the lids and then, you know, blends it out with her fingers, and it's a very good eye look. Last but not least is yet another NARS foundation, again inspired by my sister-in-law Dayang, and this is in the shade Ceylon, and this is the All Day Luminous Weightless Foundation. Again, a foundation that I personally use and I love, and I thought that this would be great for me to use to mix with my other darker foundations because a lot of the foundations I have, they are more like medium skin tone, but I don't have anything that's quite light. I thought this was a pretty light shade, but it has that yellow undertone, which is great for me to mix around, mix together with my other foundations because they are also of a yellow olive undertone. Alright guys, so we've come to the end of my beauty haul, and I hope you guys enjoyed it and found it somewhat helpful. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos from me. Don't forget to also hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out any of my uploads. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today, and I hope to see you guys soon in my next video. Bye!